same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here. Beloved, we welcome you to this exciting day on the Voice of Resurrection. God wants to set you on fire and light your fire so you can go and tell it on the mountain and everywhere. The church is not witnessing. We are not doing our job. We are not modeling the life of the Lord Jesus, so men and women are not coming into the kingdom. Actually, sometimes we're joining with them on the job and we're complaining, we're murmuring, we're engaged in strife, and there is no evidence that we have been redeemed. Hallelujah. If you've been redeemed, as my friend Andre Crouch sang, then it's time for you to say so. That's why I'm preaching messengers of resurrection, and it will come clear in a minute. The angel said to the ladies, "He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spake unto you when he was yet in Galilee, saying, the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men." Listen carefully. "And be crucified, and the third day rise again." You notice? The Son of Man must be first delivered. Beloved, you must be first delivered. You must go through some things and be resurrected yourself. You must prove the life of resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ before your message will be authentic. What would you tell people if God has not raised you from the dead and brought you out of impossibility and shown you his love and his grace in spite of you and blesses you? That's when you have a message. But some of you have even received it and now you're backsliding. You are not telling any stories. You are not preaching to anybody. And some of you are caught up with the material and talking about the material things God has done for you. That's not going to save anybody. Come on, beloved. It's time for you to go through the process of God, to embrace it and know that he's training you. You are being prepared as a messenger of resurrection. Jesus said, listen, I'm going to be betrayed. I'm going to be crucified. But on the third day, I'm going to rise. Have you risen from your death? Have you risen from your own problems and issues? Or are you still bound in them? And you are not preaching to anybody and you are not resurrecting anybody. Come on, listen. I better hurry, otherwise I won't get very far this week. Watch this. "And they remembered his words and returned from the sepulchre," listen to this, "and told all these things unto the 11 and unto all the rest." The moment the angels encountered them, the moment the word of God was brought back to their remembrance, they ran to tell it. And the same word of resurrection is coming to you this morning. As you recognize what God has done for you, as you recognize how far he has brought you, as you recognize what he forgave you of, as you recognize what he delivered you from, you better get up and tell it today. Tell it this week. Prophesy to somebody, pray for somebody, reach out to help somebody, get somebody saved. Let the word of the Lord come alive once again in your gut and preach to them, preach to them, preach to them, witness to them, challenge them. Affirm that Jesus Christ is still the Lord. Affirm that he rose again from the dead. Affirm that he's coming again to judge the world. Affirm the gospel one more time. Messengers of resurrection. If he has given you life, rise up and tell it. If he has redeemed you, rise up and tell it. If he has saved you, rise up and tell it. If he has delivered you, rise up and tell it. If he has blessed you, rise up and tell it. Run and tell it. Tell it to your fellow brethren. Tell it to his disciples. Tell it to brothers and sisters. Tell it to men and women. Tell it to young people. He still alive. He still saves. He still delivers. That's the message that has left America that must be preached. And we're not dependent on television. One-on-one is more powerful. One-on-one is more credible. One-on-one is more powerful and more delivering and more everything that you can think about, beloved. That's what God is looking for. Make disciples. Let them follow you to the kingdom. Let them follow you, not just to church, but into the kingdom. Model it. Hallelujah. One of my ministers gave me a wonderful testimony. He said a man came to him years ago in corporate America and said, "Can a Ku Klux man be saved?" He said, "Certainly." He said, "I've been watching you for a year. And your life has spoken to me. and now I'm ready to give my life to Christ. How many years have you been on your job? Do you have that testimony? Are you a messenger of resurrection power? Have you really brought anybody to Christ? Come on, you cannot just testify what the Lord has done for you and die bankrupt. You don't witness, you don't share the gospel, you don't use the opportunities God has given you to bring people to the Lord. When was the last time your testimony caused somebody to want him, or your sharing with them caused those tears to come down and they see hope in their brokenness? When this lady found out they were engaged in the wrong ministry, the Lord graciously sent an angel to encounter them and put the word of God in them. He says the women left the sepulchre. They actually ran. Hallelujah. You see? And went and told these things unto the 11 and to all the rest. And it was Mary Magdalene and Joanna and Mary the mother of James, and other women that were with them. So Luke captured the whole gang. The other gospels spoke about just the three Marys. It says, which told these things unto the apostles. Watch this. And their words seemed to them as idle tales, and they believed them not. Can you believe that? The apostolic core, when they heard of resurrection, they didn't believe it, neither did they run to tell it. But if only, as you find out as we read the book of John, the same story, only Peter and John went even to verify. Oh, beloved, isn't that where the church is? You are hearing this word of resurrection, but you are so deep in unbelief, deep in discouragement, mired in circumstances, traumatized by what you've gone through, that it seems like an idle tale. Oh, yeah, I've heard that. Oh, yeah, but you haven't done anything with it. Remember, you shall give account to the Lord of all that you have heard, of all you've been taught. It's time for you to get up. It's time for you to wake up. It's time for you to start preaching the gospel. And when somebody brings the word to you that the Lord still heals, the Lord still delivers, the Lord still saves, the Lord still restores, that you will not reject it because of unbelief. You will not doubt it because you've allowed the circumstances of life to weigh you down. You're in a difficult marriage. It looks like you are trapped forever. It will never change. That's a lie. There is resurrection. You have to believe it. You have to get up and tell it. You have to get up and prophesy to the situation. You have to get up and speak in the womb, into the womb of your life and affairs, and watch God show up, whether he shows up this year or he shows up 5 years from now. But keep living. Keep serving God. Keep testifying. People are watching us. People are looking for hope in us to see us go through our tough times and difficult times and painful times. Believe God anyway. I celebrate you for signing up once again in this resurrection army. Messengers of resurrection, awake thou that sleepest, arise from the dead. Christ shall give thee light. God bless you. Let's see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.